So ARA is Ahmedabad Racket Academy. It was formed in 2012, where our owners were in UK and they used to play tennis. And when they were studying, when they came here to Ahmedabad, they wanted some place where they can play tennis. So this land belongs to them. They are into real estate. So their fathers and forefathers were into real estate. So then they started this tennis first. They built up their own court and then they started playing. Once they started playing, people used to come and they asked for rent, and then that is how the story began. Later on in 2016-17, they thought of coming up with a football academy, and they built up this AstroTurf ground, a full pitch, and then that is how the story of football started in ARA. So I was a little bit, you know, hesitant about Gujarat because being not really keen, because as they are in the West Zone playing against Mumbai, Goa and Rajasthan, Diu Daman. So every time either Maharashtra or Goa played well, and Gujarat, Rajasthan, Diu Daman who have been thrashed by the teams there. So I was a little bit speculative, but later on I said, okay, let's take a challenge. Let's see what it is all about. Because I just think, you know, like when I started Pune FC, it started right from scratch. Nothing on the ground, and I have experience of working in that way. When me and Stuart Hall and Dr. Ashok Kumar, we started right from scratch without not having a ground at all, and we built up a team which has an AFC accreditation. Then later on when I went to Tanzania, and even there the situation was similar, so we started an academy, a club, and which now is the topmost club in the East Asia, East Africa. And there also we started the club in a very remote area with a ground, with a infrastructure of players living and a swimming pool, a gym and all. So I had that experience of, you know, developing working right from the beginning. What I thought in Ahmedabad or in Gujarat, the children were playing, there were smaller academies, but there was nothing after 18. What they will do after 18? Then that is where we wanted to give them a roadmap. And we started the second division I-League team, where we thought of once the child joins in an academy at a grassroots level, he develops himself to play into the under 13 I-League and the 15 under 18, and then gradually go to the second division I-League, and then probably if we do something good in future, we may play the I-League or the ISL. Most of the kids, when we had the academy, younger boys, and they were a little bit obese and a little bit, you know, not fit, you can say. And it was more about like children coming in a park and playing and going. So we wanted to change the culture and started proper structured, you know, academy age group wise practice. There are three ways of football, as we have always seen. One is playing for hobby, and one is having passionate, and the other one is determined or career based. So here they are more about hobby. When we were discussing about the high performance training with the parents say that, sir, we are a very social family, we need to go for social outings a lot, so he may miss couple of sessions in a week. I said, no, we won't accept it. We want them to be here regularly, and that is how then parents agreed for it, and then they are ready for practice now. And we find a difference in them now when we work on the functional training, and we work every day, so the difference is being noticed now. Earlier there was one or two smaller clubs. There is one club called Kahani before, BBFS, and there are small regional local coach players, who are ex-players, who were working earlier with these clubs and now started their own academies. So there is a good number of academies now. Recently the women's football in Gujarat is done well. In the under 14 they played semi-finals. And even in the under 17, they did well. So most of the girls have come from a small town called Patan, where in that school, the only sport they play is football, and all girls play football there. Rather than the boys, the girls team is quite stronger there. So looks good. Like I think the movement has been done now for football.
मुझे फुटबॉल बहुत अच्छा लगता है क्योंकि मैं मुझे फुटबॉल में बहुत खेलना अच्छा लगता है और मैं यही चाहती हूँ कि मैं बहुत आगे तक खेलूँ। मेरा नाम ठाकुर कमूबेन बाबूजी है और मैं 8th स्टैंडर्ड में पढ़ती हूँ। मैंने अंडर 14 खेला था, उसमें हमारे सर जी और हमारे स्कूल के जो स्टाफ लोग हैं उन्होंने बहुत हमारी मदद की थी और हम अंडर 14 में फर्स्ट आए थे।
जो पहले कुछ होता है लड़की में क्या बात है कि वो जो लड़की है वो सब खेत में काम करती है, सुबह शाम काम करती है, इसीलिए वो फिजिकली फिट है और जो स्टेमिना पावर है वो लड़कियों का बहुत ऊंचा है। जब धूप सारी धूप में भी खेलती है, शाम को भी खेलती है, कोई भी पोजीशन होती है वही पोजीशन में वो खेलने के लिए तैयार रहती है और एक घंटा दो घंटा इनको फुटबॉल जिस तरफ से तुम देते रखते हो तो वो जितने टाइम खेलने को बोलते हो इतना टाइम वो खेल के बताती है। फैसिलिटी के लिए क्या है कि जो ग्राउंड तो है मेरे पास, मगर क्या है कि अभी जो ग्राउंड फुटबॉल के लिए जो होना है चाहिए ऐसा ग्राउंड नहीं है, क्योंकि इनके चारों बाज जो कांटे का लगा हुआ है इसी के कारण जो फुटबॉल है इनमें पंचर का दिक्कत बहुत होती है, तो वो अच्छी तरह से हो जाए और फुटबॉल के जो इक्विपमेंट है वो सब मेरे को उपलब्ध हो जाए और एक एक्सपर्ट कोच जो फुटबॉल का है वो स्पेशल माधेपुरा के लिए दिया जाए तो और भी लड़की लोग अच्छी परफॉर्मेंस दे सकती है, ऐसा मेरा मानना है।
फुटबॉल इज़ ग्रोइंग बट इट्स नॉट वॉट वी वॉन्ट। वेन यू लाइक 10 ईयर्स अगो और मे बी 10-12 ईयर्स अगो यू वुड आस्क पीपल यू नो वॉट डू यू नो अबाउट फुटबॉल, दे वुड नो नथिंग, बट नाउ दे आर नोइंग लाइक एट लीस्ट समथिंग। फ्यू टाइम्स आई हैव कंसिडर्ड लाइक मे बी आई शुड हैव प्लेड फॉर सम अदर स्टेट, बट देन फुटबॉल इज़ ग्रोइंग एंड आई थिंक गुजरात कैन डू इट।
I think the biggest regret I will have that she went to a school which didn't have a football team. She, as a kid, was happy to be with friends, and we also thought that every evening she goes to the academy ground, Kahani. She gets to play the tournaments with them, and now she's at a stage where she goes, plays for the district, she plays nationals, rather than going and playing small little school tournaments, big canvases. That actually, but no doubt she's missed on tournaments like Subrato or maybe even Reliance Foundation things, which is purely inter-school. Gujarat still doesn't have that kind of visibility. In spite of the fact you had under 14 and under 17 girls reaching the semis this year in nationals, Reliance didn't find it a state where they should have come to Ahmedabad and then call the girls in there. Whatever girls went to Mumbai for trials, they went courtesy SAG. Teen is improving. But I think the organized way, sports associations, there's still not that kind of cohesion with the academies that have come up. You have ARA, you have Kahani, you have Bhaichung Bhutia schools, you have a Sun Academy, you have now Bangalore, this thing come up here. So that kind of cohesion with the, because if you have to go and play district, nationals, you got to play for India, the route is not through the academies. Ultimately, you have to come through the association, you have to come through the AIF. So that hand in glove thing is missing, you know, they walk one direction, these guys walk one direction, more cohesion is required. Gujarat State Football Association has lot of ground to cover. There are some good people like Gulab Chauhan in there, he's a veteran, I think, very respected name. This time the coach who went with them for sub-juniors, there's a gentleman called Sushil Surve. He was more like a father to these girls. They came back so happy, he took so good care of them. But he's based out of a remote place called Vapi. He owns a club in there. So if we have more Sushil Surveys in there, if we have more Gulab Chauhans in there, I think things can come up.
Gujarat is developing in football slowly. Especially I can say that we doesn't have that much infrastructure, that is a big issue for Gujarat. But newly built up this Trans-India Stadium at Kankariya, Ahmedabad, it's a giver moral courage to the spectator as well as player. Recently, we organized Santosh Trophy zonal matches here. Our chief minister, he came for an inauguration. And this stadium is inaugurated by our Sri Narendra Bhai Modi. And I found one of the best facility available for the football, especially for football game. Here we can play football, basketball, volleyball, all sports we can arrange here in Transtadia. But special turf of Transtadia is very good. Recently, one club from our Ahmedabad city, ARA club, they played second division matches here. And after seeing their performance and good football, I hope that more and more club will come up and they will try to play for I-League or ISL. We have a Adani here, we have a Torrent Power here, we have a Reliance also. And with all this facility at Transtadia, people will think, yes, why don't we go for football? If boys or girls, if they are in a position to see the good football, they will also play the good football. After seeing Indian captain, some of the boys have started playing football like that. They say even captain doesn't have that much height. But how will they score a goal? Heavy the heading, kicking, everything. So now boys also started here, even girls also. They are supporting India and they came with their tricolor here. And they also thought to go and reach this level. See, in my as a secretary, I can say government of Gujarat, especially Sports Authority of Gujarat, they are doing very well to develop in the game of football. They are building up new football ground, hostel for the boys and girls. Recently, they inaugurated one very good hostel at Himmatnagar. And it is made only for girls. There, girls, they having all facility, not only football, volleyball, football, badminton, swimming, all facilities are with the athletic track. Same way, they made one infrastructure at Nadiad, then another at Godhra. And recently, I have come to know that Patan also, they are maybe within a 15 or 20 days, they will inaugurate new stadium like stadium type facility. Previously, when team is going for any national championship, hardly we got one or two set of uniform. But now we are giving two sets of uniform, tracksuit, kit, and lodging, boarding, all facility, 15 to 20 days coaching camp also. So we are giving full support to the players as well as official team official also. So after seeing all this facility, I hope that in coming year we'll have a teams from Gujarat and we'll try. If possible, I'll request my president also, because he is from Reliance. I'll ask him to at least support to Gujarat football. So at least we can field one team or two teams from Gujarat.
Gujarat, as we all know, has untapped potential for football. Though for cricket and all we do have teams, but for football there is none. Also, the teams which are playing for the I-Leagues and ISL, there are none which are there in, like none of them are represented from Gujarat actually. So we thought that, you know, let's go to a place where it's going to be difficult for us, but that would be the most fruitful for us too. So Gujarat has a lot of academies, a lot of players who do want to play as a professional, but they don't know how to go over there, either to play for the I-Leagues or the ISL or for Indian team. So our first preference came to Gujarat in that sense.
Gujarat is more or less called the business hub of India. It is pioneer in business. Like, they take innovation very easily. Like, they are very upcoming and upfront for anything that is new. They embrace it. And the ease of business in Gujarat is prolific. Like, there is no, it is second to none. You know, if you want to start up something, I believe Gujarat is the place. And as there is no one in the West region, the entire West region, we thought like Gujarat is the perfect place to start with. If you would have been to Kerala, okay, Kerala is the gold mine, Northeast, Kolkata, Goa, they are the gold mines for football talent. But why so? Because everyone was focusing there. No one is focusing onto this part of the India. So we thought, okay, we would do that. We would take the plunge. And that's why we are here. Like, even if you'll see the strategic plan of AIFF, the one which has been released recently, you will see the number of stadiums which are there in Gujarat. When you will see the infrastructure which is there in Gujarat already, it is fourth highest in India. We have got around 11 proper grounds where the matches can be done, official matches can be played at. Okay, so that plays a huge role. It's just that people don't realize it. With the FA, the thing is, it has been run by people who have this orthodox manner of working. It needs to be changed. It needs to be changed a little bit. Like, you know, there should be privatization into football as well. That's what we believe. But okay, there should be a youth influx. Okay, because they have the idea. They know what is being run, like how it has been run. It cannot run how it was being run like since 80s or 90s like that. You need to take the model of Premier League as well. You need to incorporate that into the Indian football system as well. Now, what has been done by, I guess, Richard Hood. Okay, that was a brilliant program. What he started, Baby League. He adopted it from South America. Okay, Uruguay was his model, where he could see like how the kids would start playing at a very early age. And that has been a success. We did a program with them, All India Football Federation, the Baby League of Ahmedabad was done by us. And now we are taking it further to next, like different cities. We are going to do it in 4 cities this time.
ARA also have been approached by one ISL team to be the partnership. It started and it halted, but yes, we won't be surprised to that in Ahmedabad very soon an I-League team or ISL team would be there. And because of Transstadia and having the only footballing stadium which has a beautiful world-class infrastructure, I think very soon the nation will find one good team from Ahmedabad, and Gujarat would be again, as I said, on the map of Indian football.